Experts say after that much time in space, their bodies have changed. And so now Sunny and Butch will have to retrain their bodies to Earth's gravity.
And there you have it. The side hatch is open for the first time since September.
Our first glimpse of the four astronauts back on Earth. First emerges Nick Hague, who spent 171 days in space alongside Russia's Alexander Gorbunov. Both men went to space in September. Then out comes Needham's own.
That is none other than Suni Williams.
Suni Williams sliding out with a big smile and a big wave, assisted up and away, giving another wave as she's carted off to get tended to by medical personnel. Same too for Butch Wilmore, helped out and wheeled away. NASA saying it's normal after so many months in space.
Coming from a microgravity environment can wreak havoc on the body, so it is customary and just standard procedure for all of our long-term space residents to get assistance.
And experts say living in that microgravity for 9 months makes a huge impact on their bodies.
The heart doesn't have to push against gravity, so the heart gets weaker. So the bones become weaker in space.
When you're living in a long-duration microgravity mission, you do lose some of your muscle mass. Your heart weakens because it's not having to pump your blood against the force of gravity. And even funny things like your eyesight can change because the shape of your eyeball is a little bit different in microgravity.
As Suni and Butch get acclimated to Earth's gravity, they'll next get to see their families, including Sunny's mom and sister.
We're both very, very excited to have her back on Earth safely.
And NASA tonight saying that they'll also test the astronauts to learn how their bodies changed over time in space. Sean Chiabot, WCVB News Center 5.